Well, it's Friday the 10th of December. It's about 8:45, I think. And it's the day for my epic 25,000 metre swim in aid of the Scottish Taekwondo Poomsae team and their trip to India for the Commonwealth Championships in January in India. So this is Grangemouth, this is the venue for my swim today. As you can see, looking in great shape. And you can see the snow still outside, although thankfully it's thawing out. I'm feeling a bit nervous about today, if I'm being honest. I think the gravity of what I'm about to do is finally hit home, albeit just this morning when I got up. But all the preparations are in place, I think, so just gonna see how it goes. And hopefully, by the time I come out later on this evening, I'll be able to walk. But I'm hoping for some of the team members to come along later in the day and give a little bit of support. I know that Howard and Nigel and Angie have said that they'll try and come along and cheer me on for a bit. Hopefully I'll actually hear them, considering my head is going to be submerged in water for most of the day. But yeah, hopefully it should go fine, so I'll switch off. I need to go and do a bit of stretching and get ready. And I'll report back when I have a sizeable break. Right. So it's about 10:15. I've been swimming for an hour and 15 minutes. I've just finished length 140 and it's going alright so far. I'm trying to find my rhythm and I think I've done a pretty good job. My arms are starting to seize a little bit, so I'm just trying to relax and get rid of the lactic acid. But I'm feeling fairly relaxed at the moment. It feels a bit strange being back in the water. To be fair, I haven't done as much preparation as I should have done for this, but no, it's going well so far. Just really, really thirsty, drinking quite a lot. I think I'm going to have an energy rush and then a sugar low later on, so that's the update so far. So we're going well. Still a long way to go, but I'm hoping that I'll just try and keep myself occupied. When you're swimming like this on your own, you tend to think of the silliest things to try and keep you occupied, so I'll report back to you when I can. I've had too long a break already, so I'll see you later. Why? Do you want me to tell you when I'm on my last 10 legs?
Yeah, I'll come and walk.
Living in the tent of the
so I'll give you something. Give me something to get, right?
Some incentive, I'll give you that. Probably incentive for embarrassment.
I'm good. I'm actually thinking that this guy's maybe going to drown, actually, in a minute. He came back to school a minute ago. Wasn't it? It was like back to the car.
Well, you do get a little bit of a obviously, you can turn the wrong pieces. Swimming lessons on the core, so I have to get out of that lane and just run with the normal product. But that's what's happening. Just kind of runs the window. Except we'll probably go sprint. Go right diagonally across the pool.
I'm going in to join him.
I think he's gone back to the 70s with that car, Ken.
I was just telling him how nice it was.
Difference of opinion.
It's very fashionable.
Well,
on some people.
So here's Ian. What stage are we at now, Ian?
We've done 160 legs, which is 4,000 metres.
4,000 metres. And what proportion of the total swim is that?
That
16%, yeah. And it's only, what time is it now?
Just gone half ten.
Yeah. So you're on course then to do this pretty quickly.
Hopefully, anyway. I've got an incentive now because I've been told by Nigel I have to take my trunks off the last day.
So we're going to be gathering a big crowd together for that. What kind of time is that going to be, do you reckon?
Well, I've no idea, somehow I'm not quite sure.
So basically we've got to deploy people throughout the day to make sure there's somebody here to see that, capture it on film.
Well, hopefully the lifeguards will always be on here, so...
And the Falkirk Herald will also capture that as well,
well
I take it.
Well, if you ask yeah. nicely, it might happen, but I'm not sure I'll have the confidence or the energy to to move anything at the end of this. No, it's going well so far, but I'm just trying to chill out slightly because my arms are starting to seize slightly. So.
Okay. And you're doing 20 length blocks at the moment?
Yeah. Managing to try and find a comfortable rhythm. I tried to do, I did 40 for the first lot, but
okay.
it was a bit too long.
Yeah.
And then I tried 10, but it was too short.
Right.
I was finding that motivation wise, 20 was okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's going well so far.
That's good. Well, it's a marathon effort. It's 25,000 metres, is that right?
Yes.
Which is 25 kilometres.
25 kilometres. We've done four so far, so slowly but surely.
Oh, it's pretty good. So we'll sign off just now and we'll talk to you later.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye. So how many are we at now then, Ian?
Just finished 200.
200, which is a fifth of the way through?
Yes.
And it's only 11 o'clock?
It's 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
So that's 2 hours to do a fifth of it. Is
yes.
that right? Yeah.
Pretty much.
So we're talking about 10 hours then.
I think so.
So you started at 9, you'd be on track to finish about 7-ish. Is that right?
Yes. I'm having trouble processing information. Yeah, well, about 7 o'clock.
Yeah. Still looking pretty fresh.
Not too bad, just drinking plenty of fluids, so
yeah.
Because it's very hard to tell that you're sort of getting dehydrated apart from sort of like a dry mouth.
Yeah.
You're still sweating when you're exercising, but
sure.
You can tell when you're cold, so
yeah,
but not too bad so far. Not too bad.
Looking good.
Once you get to the halfway point I feel a lot better because it's almost feels like an uphill climb at the moment, you know, with it.
Yeah.
100, 200, then
sure.
Obviously.
Yeah.
I think once we pass that halfway mark, I feel a lot better, and then can sort of focus on the end goal as well.
Sure. Yeah.
So yeah, not too bad. So.
Well, you're doing well, and it's a mammoth effort. So keep it up, and we'll talk to you again soon.